Hello, welcome everyone. It's Lisa with Harmony House Art. Thanks so much for being here with me. So this is a little different. I got a lot of requests for the sheer alcohol ink flower tutorials that I didn't do a very good job of explaining what I was doing and whatever. So I'm going to try to do a better job on this one, and that includes talking my way through it. Okay, so I'll show you the tools I'm using. This is a Ranger hand blower. That's about my favorite way to move ink around. The alcohol I'm using, I put it in one of these little needle nose bottles for better control. I'm using the 99%, but the 91 works also. In this needle nose bottle, I've got half of the Pinata Pearl and half alcohol. So it's a diluted solution. It's a little thinner than normal. The other colors I'm going to be using are just the Snow Cap White and the Ranger Pitch Black for the center. Okay. So the first thing I do is put down the alcohol first, then I'm going to use the Snow Cap. I don't know why I'm holding the pearl. I'm going to use the Snow Cap. This first layer of outer petals, I want a little more white in than just plain pearl. So that's what we're going to do for this first layer. So if you put the white down first, it stains the surface, and you can't, even with alcohol, you really can't get it completely out. So hopefully I won't do that this time. Always helps to shake everything up, because a lot of times the pigments will settle in the bottom. So ink or alcohol first, Snow Cap. So now I'm going to start adding some pearl. So what I'll do is put the pearl down, then the white, and then the alcohol. Let's see how that looks. Thank you. So what I'm doing, I'm kind of going in between. So I'm going to put the purl here, here, and here. And the more layers you make, of course, the more opaque it is. So that's what I don't want to do, especially for this demo. I'm going to leave it as sheer as I can. One of the things I want to point out, most people can hold it and squeeze it like this, but because of the arthritis in my thumb, that's why I'm holding it like this and just squeezing with the fingers. Honestly, you could let it go just like this and work on the center, and that would be beautiful. I think I'm probably going to put one more layer of purl only. Just trying to get it all dry before I put in the pitch black in the center. I'm just going to drop a drop of pitch black in here, and then if I need to, I'll move it around with the micro tool. Dry this with the hand blower. And now that it's dry, what I'm going to try to do is add a little bit of alcohol right here at the edges and blow it out into the petals. That helps the center look seated into the flower instead of just sitting on top. Thank you.
Okay. I'll just get that all dry. Then you can just take a little snow cap into your palette and
dot the center until you're happy.
I try to figure out which way the light's coming from. I think it's coming from this way on this one, so I'll try to make this side of the center a little bit brighter. I've also noticed that it helps if your snow cap gets a little bit drier, not dried out, but like to the point of being tacky. It does a better job of making the little center dots. Okay, so to finish this piece off, I'm going to use the Kamar varnish, and if you do use this, take it outside or someplace well ventilated because it's very heavy fumes. So let me take it out and I'll spray it and we'll come right back. Okay, here's the finished piece. Okay, one last thing I wanted to show you is the matting. I think most ink artists that work on Yupo or this graphics or Nara paper usually just mat it when they're done and ready to sell it or give it away. So I'll link everything, of course, in the description. The matting comes with a mat board. There you go. Beautiful. Okay.
Okay, I'll bring you in for a close look. Again, thank you so much for being here. I'm just grateful to every one of you and can't wait to see you on the next video. Bye-bye.
Thank you.